Over the weekend, Matt Gaetz decided to finally hold an event in his own rally. And of course, he can't do it alone, so he had to bring along Marjorie Taylor Greene. I guess maybe he thought that would kind of get the crowds going a little bit. But things didn't go as planned. In fact, Matt Gaetz at his own reelection campaign kickoff rally seemed like he would rather be anywhere else in the world than sitting in his own district. And Marjorie Taylor Greene, as I said, did a good job trying to work the crowd, but as you can see from this clip, didn't exactly do such a great job. Here it is. This is Matt Gaetz campaign kickoff rally in Northwest Florida over the weekend.
Entered in the congressional record that we can now expose on that laptop. Here's what we do after that. We need to impeach Kamala Harris. Because you can't encourage and promote and raise money for criminal rioters and expect to serve the interest of the people, the great people in the United States. That is a conflict of interest.
So before I talk about Marjorie Greene's idiotic plan there, let's take a moment to analyze what was actually happening in that clip. Now, I'm sure when Marjorie Taylor Greene was speaking afterwards, you heard the applause, right? Sounded like what, a good 7-8 people clapping? Do you ever wonder why sometimes they show these events and don't show you the crowd? You may not be able to see it, but you can hear it. You can hear that there is either nobody there or the people that are there don't agree with what they're hearing from those speakers. There wasn't raucous applause. There wasn't people standing up, giving ovations, blocking the camera, which of course would have happened had they done that because of the camera angle there. Nope, just a couple of people. Woo! Yeah. All right. That's it. That's all Matt Gaetz and Marjorie Taylor Greene could muster in this deep red area of the state of Florida. Again, I live here. I know how red it is. I know how Republican it is. But I also know that Matt Gaetz is, of course, in very serious trouble, and I'm not just talking about the investigation. This is one of the few times that Matt Gaetz has bothered to show his face in his district within the last year. The guy doesn't ever come here, and of course, that's why he now has an approval rating, again, in this deep red Republican district that's underwater. He no longer has a 50% approval rating here. Now, if he is the Republican nominee, he is going to win this election. Let's be clear about that. It sucks to have to say it, but I'm afraid that's the way this district works. The question is, can he even make it through the primary? His primary opponents, much like Marjorie Taylor Greene's primary opponents, are hitting them on the fact that they have done absolutely nothing for their districts, that they're never there. You're out there touring the rest of the country, but you can't even be bothered to come back home. Now let's talk about Marjorie Taylor Greene's idiotic plan, right? We're going to impeach Biden because of his son's laptop, which has been in Matt Gaetz's hands, at least the hard drive, which he entered into the congressional record. Good for you. But if there was something on it, wouldn't you have told us? I refuse to believe that you had it and didn't even bother to plug it in to see what was on there. That's just not a thing that you would do. Rudy Giuliani has also claimed to have had possession of it. So has Tucker Carlson. And if any of those individuals had it and had seen anything that was criminal, it would have already been reported on well over a year ago when they all had their hands first upon it. So no, you're not going to impeach Joe Biden for anything like that. Secondly, Kamala Harris, not Kamala, as Marjorie Taylor Greene loves to say because she has no respect for women of color. You're going to impeach her for what? Tweeting out links to raise money for Black Lives Matter supporters? That's not illegal. So I don't even know where you're going with that, but best of luck, because neither of those things are going to happen. You're just going to continue to look like the idiotic creep that you are. So that's what happened. Marjorie Taylor Greene, Matt Gaetz finally came back to Gaetz's district, and not only could they not even muster a decent crowd, but they couldn't even come up with a cogent plan of what they would do if Republicans win back power in the midterms. I'd say that's pretty pathetic. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for fresh content every single day of the week. Just smash that subscribe button, and of course, don't forget to like, comment, and share the video.